Yo, 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 guys. Today, I had a life-changing revelation. For years, I'd been watching these guys on YouTube construct these incredible performances and songs out of just a loop pedal. And I was like, man, I wish I could do that. But I always thought I needed special expertise or super expensive equipment to do it. Since I couldn't afford a dope Boss Loopstation pedal, I had to get creative. My first attempt was using a plugin called Mobius in Ableton, ripping out all the keys on a mechanical keyboard, putting duct tape and pieces of thin wood on it to act like pedals, mapping those keys to controls in Mobius in Ableton. It was a mess. My next attempt was using the Ditto Mic Looper. Couple problems. Only XLR ins and outs. You couldn't separate individual tracks, so it wasn't really ideal. I wanted to make looping as easy as possible without ever having to leave my DAW. Enter MIDI mapping.
Superhero landing.
MIDI mapping in Ableton lets you take any control on a MIDI controller and map it to any control in Ableton. Turns out, the keyboard I've had since I was a little kid taking piano lessons has had the capability to be a full-fledged loop pedal all along. The sustain pedal that came with it outputs MIDI.
Hooray!
How did I do it? Great question. Let me walk you through it. First, make sure the pedal is plugged into the sustain slot on your keyboard. Then you're gonna need a MIDI to USB cord. Remember, when you're plugging in the MIDI to USB cord to your keyboard, the in on the cord goes to the out on the keyboard, and the out on the cord goes to the in on the keyboard. Now, while looking at Ableton, press the sustain pedal and make sure it's sending MIDI signals by looking in the top right corner of the screen. Next, go into Ableton's preferences, go to the Link MIDI tab, and make sure that track and remote are both turned on in the settings. Click the MIDI key in the top right and map the pedal step to the session record button. The session record button records into a clip in any armed scene in session view, unlike normal record, which records into arrangement view. Make sure MIDI quantization is set to 1 bar, so that you have some lead time between when you hit the pedal and when the recording starts. And that's it. Now let's make a quick track. I can press the pedal and lay down some drums. Then I can lay down a bass. I can lay down a pad. And finally, lay down a lead. And there you go. You're looping in Ableton in a few simple steps with hardware you probably have at home. If you don't have a keyboard that has a sustain pedal, you can buy a really, really cheap MIDI pedal on Amazon or any other site and map it exactly the same way. Great, I hope that was helpful, and I hope it gave you a new perspective on what you can do with the gear that you already have using Ableton for the powerful tool that it is. Don't forget to leave a like and a comment below, and hit the subscribe button to hear me drop more knowledge on Ableton as I get the knowledge dropped on me. I'll see you guys in the next video.